Today we are going to talk about smart grid and energy of our nation, as well as security, cyber security and infrastructure security. When we think about the grid, the North American grid is the greatest achievement of engineering in the 20th century, according to the National Academy of Engineering. It underpins our economy, our quality of life, and everything we use depends on reliable, disturbance-free, affordable electricity. However, this whole system from end to end has a total system efficiency of only about 43%. It means we waste about 56% of our energy either at the production or during transfer or at the end use.
Kilowatts upon kilowatts of power that we generate, predominantly by burning fossil fuels, gets lost in our nation's electric transmission system. However, U of M professor Massoud Amin says that doesn't have to be the case. Through his work and the research of other experts, many of them at the University of Minnesota, Amin is proposing a switch to a smart electric grid that includes our household appliances, how power plants operate, even the cars we drive.
It's going to require a much larger high voltage retrofitting of the system, of the grid, with a high voltage direct current DC power lines to enable this system for the 21st century.
New power lines are only one part of the equation. Amin proposes a four-step approach to redefining the way the world creates, transports, and uses its power. And the first step is a better backbone. In other words, improved electric infrastructure, or power lines. Next is power generated from greener, renewable sources such as solar, wind, and biomass. The third step includes breaking away from foreign oil and instead using the electricity we're producing from green sources to power our cars. And finally, improving overall efficiency by using highly efficient appliances in our homes, and in this case, by using cars that operate more efficiently.
When you look at fuel cycle efficiency, the same barrel of oil that goes through refineries, goes through a traditional vehicle, gives you about 1,600 miles per barrel of oil. 1,400 to 1,600 miles per barrel of oil going through refineries with the efficiency that we have. The same barrel of oil, if you put it through electricity, but put it through a plug-in vehicle, hybrid vehicle, would give you about 2,300 miles. So right there, you're getting a 35 to 40% increase in efficiency using the same fuel source.
Let's run Amin's car example through the four steps. Now first, you have better, more reliable electric infrastructure to transport energy to your home where you plug your car in. That electricity is generated by clean sources. You're getting away from fossil fuels because you're using clean electric energy to power your car. And unlike gas, which Amin says is less than 20% efficient, you're using the highly efficient electricity coming from those improved power lines. The key to making the smart grid a success is integrating everything into the smart grid the same way we just did with a family car.
When you think about cities such as Minneapolis, to transform this city into smart grid city, retrofitting buildings, homes, with the sensors and communication devices that are smart and connecting the whole system that is secure, provides the electricity, clean electricity, with the price, affordable price, and with the ability to engage customers.
So creating a new smart grid network to power everything that requires power would save us money, make for a cleaner environment, and provide more reliable electricity by, for example, reducing the chance of a blackout. On top of those things, Amin says the smart grid would also make us safer.
Smart grid has to have security built in every of the devices, in every of one of the chips we talked about, and communication protocols we talked about. Here we have the 35W bridge. Unfortunately, I witnessed the collapse of 35W bridge in August of 2007.
When the 35W bridge was rebuilt, it was obviously made strong enough to support its load. But the builders also inserted sensors throughout the structure, making it smart enough to support itself as well.
Sensors built into 35W bridge cost less than 0.5% of total cost, but they enable situational awareness of what's going on, what are the stresses in the bridge, what's the chemical buildup, what's the material failure. That's exactly what we're talking about.
Amin says sensors in the smart grid would not only warn about and prevent blackouts, but would also stop cyber terror attacks in their tracks. And every aspect of this technology is available now. Amin says all it takes is the leadership to implement the smart grid, so that several years from now, an improved grid and better way of life are thought of in the same way we now think of things like smartphones.
When we think about other industries such as telecom that have used what technologies we have in terms of wireless, in terms of caller ID, those 30 years ago, they were just an idea. But now today, they're a given. We all have wireless telephones. There are about 2 billion people in the world that are using wireless technology.